love you, Arizona. Your mountains, deserts, and streams, the rise of Dos Cabezas, and the outlaws I see in my dreams. I love you, Arizona. Superstitions and all, the warmth you give at sunrise, your sunsets put music in a soul. Ooh, Arizona, you're the magic in me. You're the lifeblood of me. I love you, Arizona. Desert dust on the wind, the sage and cactus are blooming, and the smell of the rain on your skin. Ooh, Arizona, you're the magic in me. You're the lifeblood of me.
I was out walking one morning for pleasure, espied a cowpuncher a-riding along. His hat was thrown back and his spurs were a-jingling, and as he approached he was singing this song.
Whoopie-tie-i-o, get along, you little dogie, it's your misfortune and none of mine. Whoopie-tie-i-o, get along, you little dogie, you know that Wyoming will be your new home.
It's early in the spring when we round up the dogie. We mark 'em and brand 'em and bob off their tails. Round up the horses, load up the chuck wagon, then send the dogies out on the long trail.
Whoopie-tie-i-o, get along, you little dogie, it's your misfortune and none of mine. Whoopie-tie-i-o, get along, you little dogie, you know that Wyoming will be your new home.
Your mother was raised away down in Texas, where the ginseng weed and the sanders grow. We'll feed you up on prickly pear choya, and then send you loping to old Idaho.
Whoopie-tie-i-o, get along, you little dogie, it's your misfortune and none of mine. Whoopie-tie-i-o, get along, you little dogie, you know that Wyoming will be your new. Oh,
that Wyoming will be your new home.
First off, this is totally unscripted. I didn't even talk to Fred today about what this was going to be and everything else. My name's Dave Parnell. First off, let me just look around this room. This podium right here, when we came out to the MO Club 14 years ago, we had a thing with falling down and everything else. This is the most beautiful podium in Tucson. It was designed and built by this guy. Not built, but it was came from down the two-back, Ray Flores and all that. Then look at that picture right over there by Glenn Hopkinson, and that's where your ancestors crossed Lee's Ferry. Okay, now I'll get back to where I met this guy when I started in business here in 1967. I made a phone call one day. I said, you know, I was renting a place, and I thought, you know, it'd probably be better if I owned my own building and paid rent to myself instead of a landlord. So I started in 67, about 1970 or 69, I made a call to Lynch Engineering Construction, which was owned by the father of a guy I had gone to college with here as an undergraduate. And the lady at the answer the phone said, well, Mr. Lynch doesn't own this company anymore, Mr. Pace does. And I thought a minute. I said, let me speak to Mr. Pace. So he came, we talked, drew out this little plan and everything else for this building. And then after we got the building built and everything was going fine, and Fred would stop by frequently, how you doing? The copper mines were doing great. Business was really good. And we were a small company that were very fortunate to get a great start. So Fred and I started going to lunch once in a while. And then, you know, once in a while, that was before the Jimmy Carter, you know, nixed the three martini lunches. So we'd have a drink once in a while. So we did this, and we ended up buying a boat one day at lunch. This is a long story, but I'm gonna make it short. So we had the boat quite a while, and our kids had fun with it. Alan, you and Jody, remember the Rennell boat at Apache Lake? You guys can shake your heads on that. And then we bought, Fred's office was on Winston Street there, and then we said, well, maybe we ought to get rid of this boat, and we'll buy a little piece of real estate, and we built the building, which we still own today, and we built and had a number of buildings since then. And first off, I tell you, our overhead was really low because we would stop on the way home from work, and our office was the nearest bar where we stopped. And we didn't have any stationary issues because we did our business on bar napkins. And we did this for a long time. And we finally through an attorney friend of ours, said, you guys got to quit this. And we put this together, this partnership called Parpac for Parnell and Pace. We're in business 45 years. And I got to tell you, the blessing that it's been. And to know this man and the friendship and everything else, I just had to get up. Fred, I can't say enough for, and I wish all of you could have anything in life that I've had with this man. It has just been unbelievable. Thank Fred, you. Happy birthday.